I'm going to talk about trusses today. You may have wondered why bridges, roofs, and other heavy structures have this weird triangular pattern structures, interconnected triangles, and not any other kind of geometric design, like squares or rectangles or whatever. The reason for that is that this particular design of interconnected web triangles is very efficient, and it distributes loads like really well. They handle both compression and tension equally well, and that's why they're efficient. A truss is a structure of interconnected members webbed as triangular patterns, and the overall assembly behaves as one single unit or one single object. Another feature of many trusses are they have zero force members or zero force segments. These are segments or members of truss systems that is neither under compression nor under tension. So what are they doing then? Well, they provide stability, because in case some other members fail, they can compensate for the failed member. So first we need to identify zero force members. So there are two ways to identify zero force members. One is if there are two non-collinear members that meet in an unloaded point. Both are zero force members. So if there was a segment that came to a point, let's say P, and so these are two non-collinear members, in that case both of them will be zero force members. And another thing is they are unloaded, so there's no load anywhere at point P. So if there was something like this, then both of these things, PH and PA, will be zero force members. The second reason why some segments are zero force members, if three members meet in an unloaded joint, of which two are collinear, then the third member is a zero force member. So let's see. The first requirement is they have to be unloaded. So point B is loaded, so it's out of the question. Point C is loaded again. Now point D and point G are unloaded. There are three members. Two of them are collinear, the third one is non-collinear, the same thing with G. So in that case, this will be a zero force member, and this will be a zero force member. The next thing we're going to do is find out the global forces. So because we have a pin here, there's going to be a force going upwards, and this will be A, Y, and there'll be one going in the X direction. But because there's no force in the X direction, we can just remove this because it's going to be zero. Similarly, E will have a force upwards, and we're going to call it EY. So the thing is, all of them have to equal zero because this is a static structure. So it's going to be AY plus minus 2 minus 3 plus EY. It's going to be zero. That's our first equation. So the goal is to find out AY and EY. And we can do that by taking the moment around A. And that has to be equal to zero, because again, it's a static variation. Now, in this case, EY is going to be, okay, let's take this as 4 inches. All of them are 4 inches. And in that case, EY into 16 minus 4, I'm sorry, 3 over here into 8 minus 2 into 4 has to be 0. And that will be EY is equal to 24, 32, EY will be 2. And because EY plus AY has to be 5, AY will be 3. Next, we need to find the forces in each segment. First, we are going to focus on joint A. So, we're just going to take care of joint A right now. So, all the forces in the vertical are going to be 0 at joint A. So, AY, which is 3. Plus FAH is the force of at like in the segment AH into sine 45, because we're just taking care of the vertical axis right now. It's going to be 0. In that case, F A H is going to be minus 3 into root 2, because sine 45 is from root 2. Similarly, we have to do the same thing for the horizontal. The forces in horizontal is going to be 0 at point A, at joint A. In that case, F A B plus F E H into cos 45. Cos 45, because we're taking care of the horizontal, is going to be 0. We know F A H is minus 3 root 2, so F A B is going to be minus of minus, which is going to be 3 root 2 into 1 by root 2. So F A B is going to be just 3.
We can do this whole procedure by taking the horizontal forces to be 0, the vertical forces to be 0, and we can do the same procedure for all joints and find out the forces in each segment.